Welcome back, students. Today I'm with economics, standard 12. Do you agree? Agree or disagree questions from question bank. Okay, before starting, they will give a statement and you have to tell whether you are agreeing with the above statement or disagree. Means in short, it is true or false, right? But most of the students make a common mistake. They directly start writing, I disagree with the following statement, or I disagree with the above statement. Above, dekho to statement hi nahi hota hai. This is the common mistake most of the students do. So first of all, you have to write down the statement and then tell ki I agree with the above statement or I disagree with the above statement. Okay? तो अबाउ बोले तो रेफरेंस होना चाहिए ना. अबाउ यू हैव टू राइट द स्टेटमेंट देन राइट डाउन आई एग्री और डिसएग्री व्हाटएवर. ओके, सो दिस वाज माय फर्स्ट पॉइंट कि एग्री एंड डिसएग्री हो तो राइट डाउन द स्टेटमेंट एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन. नाउ पार्ट टू, व्हेन एवर आई से व्हेन एवर इट इज अ डिसएग्री स्टेटमेंट, इट मीन्स इट्स अ फॉल्स स्टेटमेंट, राइट? यू हैव टू करेक्ट इट. So this, your job increases, you have to correct it and then explain ki why it is wrong, means why do you disagree with it. Okay, agree ho to bhi explain karna hai, disagree ho to bhi explain karna hai. But in case if you disagree with the statement, then the answer turns longer. Disagree case mein answer turns longer because you have to correct that statement and then write down the explanation. Right? But if you agree with the above statement, just 4 or 5 points are enough. Fine? Okay. Now let us start with your question bank solution. First question was, the scope of microeconomics is unlimited. Scope of microeconomics is unlimited. Microeconomics. Recollect lesson number 1. What is microeconomics? Look at the spelling, M-I-C-R-O. Yes, micro means small, right? Micro means small. So originally, this is a Greek word. Most of the economics word arrive from Greek. Greek word, micros, and spelling is M-I-K-R-O-S, right? In economics, we write the spelling as M-I-C-R-O, but original word is M-I-K-R-O, which means small. This is our point number 2. Because what was my first point? I disagree with the above statement. And microeconomics means it's a study of individual consumer, individual producer, individual company, individual unit. So it is a study of one thing, right? So this was point number 2. Point number 3, it is a study of a tree, not a forest. See how beautiful it is explained in economics. It is a study of single tree, but in detailed. We are studying one tree in detailed. That is a single tree study and not a forest, right? And next point, it is also called as a slicing method. Slice matlab just like a bread slice. How do we have slice? Single slice. So we are studying one bread, that is one slice, which is nothing but microeconomics. Okay, so this was our next point. After that, it considers partial equilibrium. Partial bole to single. Partial, part is studied, that is a single. So that is about microeconomics. Okay, so do you say that it is unlimited? No, it is limited because it studies one at a time, right? Okay, microeconomics is mostly based on all diagrams. Okay, and most of the concepts are introduced by Professor Marshall, Alfred Marshall, right? You don't have to write all these things. 4 or 5 points are enough. I repeat the points again. It is originally derived from which word? Greek word, that is mikros, which means small. This was point number one. It is a study of one tree, not a forest. This was point number two. Then it is also called as a slicing method. This was point number three. Then examples you can write. It is a study of consumer, one producer, one household, one firm, etc., etc. One. It means it is a small concept. Correct? It is a study of partial equilibrium. Partial bole to, it studies one at a time. Most of the points are covered. No need to explain more because this is a basic part. Right? So this was my first agree-disagree. Second first agree-disagree was microeconomics is different from macroeconomics. Yes or no? Obviously, I agree with the above statement. Microeconomics and macro, are they same? Agar same hote to spelling alag na hota, concept alag na hota, right? Okay, so yes, I agree with the above statement because microeconomics and macroeconomics are totally different. I've already explained microeconomics just now, but just remember first lesson's distinguish part. कि माइक्रो MICRO एंड मैक्रो दैट इज MACRO. व्हाट इज द ओरिजिनल वर्ड इन माइक्रो? इन माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स ओरिजिनली डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम MIKRO दैट इज अ ग्रीक वर्ड व्हिच मींस स्मॉल यूनिट, राइट? एंड MICRO इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम सेम ग्रीक वर्ड बट MIKRO. ओरिजिनल वर्ड क्या है? MIKRO, MAKRO. Okay? It means small, it means large. Fine? After that, second point I've already explained, it is a study of tree, it is a study of forest. Right? Forest bole to, it studies all trees at a time. It means total production, national income, aggregate or total demand, total savings. All are included in MACRO, that is macroeconomics. Fine. Next is, it is a general equilibrium and micro was a partial equilibrium. Partial bole to, one thing at a time, that is a slicing method. And this MACRO is called as a lumping method. Lump, bread ka lump hota hai. If you study the whole bread at a time, it is a lumping method, which is a part of a macroeconomics, MACRO. And if you study its slice, it is called as a microeconomics. I hope I'm clear. Yes? Okay, shall I continue? Most of the points I have covered now. All are in distinguished pattern, but you have to write it one after other. टोटल फाइव पॉइंट्स आर देयर, हम उसके टेन बनाएंगे. हाउ? वन पॉइंट ऑफ माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, वन पॉइंट ऑफ मैक्रो, अगेन माइक्रो माइक्रो लाइक दिस वी विल कंप्लीट द आंसर इन टेन पॉइंट्स. तो एग्जामिनर विल बी हैप्पी विद यू. यस, इसको सब कुछ आता है. फुल मार्क्स, ऑलमोस्ट फुल मार्क्स. ओके, नाउ प्रोसीडिंग टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. Next question was regarding MU and T, that is marginal utility and total utility. The question is, when total utility is maximum, marginal utility is zero. Correct? Yes, I agree with the above statement. Before that, what is TU and what is MU? See, TU bole to total utility. And MU bole to marginal utility. Now what's that? In textbook also they have taken an example of all food items. Now this is a mango season, so obviously I will take example of mangoes. Okay, now if I eat I'm considering small mango. If I eat one mango, I get some satisfaction. Okay, if I eat more second mango, third mango, my satisfaction derived from 4-5 mangoes. Suppose I eat 5 mangoes, We are just imagining that I eat 5 mangoes. I ate 5 mangoes. Whatever satisfaction I receive from all these 5 mangoes is called TU, total utility, because it is derived from all 5 units, all 5 mangoes, right? So satisfaction from all 5 mangoes is called as a TU, fine? And what is MU? Satisfaction received from 5th mango. 5th mango. See, what is TU? Satisfaction from 5 mangoes. Fine. And what is MU? Satisfaction from only 5th mango. That is additional mango. Satisfaction received from additional mango is called as a MU. Okay. Now, if you compare the chart of TU and MU, observe the chart. TU goes on increasing at a decreasing rate. MU continuously goes on decreasing. Now look at the level where TU is maximum but MU is zero. In our example, we have taken example of mango in case of both TU and MU. We are getting one point where TU and MU both are equal, that is 32 or something. 32. Okay. So that maximum TU is 30, at the same time MU is 0. MU is 0 bole to I want to stop at that level. I don't want more mangoes. See, here I'm considering all small mangoes. Don't consider big mango. Kyunki big hoga to ek khake bas. ऐसे होता है, बड़ा सा एक खाएंगे तो बस हो गया. We don't want that because we have to prove this TU and MU concept. So for proving this concept, we are taking small small units of mangoes so that I can eat one mango, two mango, three, four, हाँ बाबा, five खाने के बाद stop हो गया because mangoes are smaller. So in this case, in this example, mangoes are smaller. Fine. So now what was our question? TU is maximum, MU is zero. Agree or disagree? Yes, we agree with the above statement. We have to write a definition of TU. What are the points now? Number one, I agree with the above statement. Statement must be written above. Now, in that case only you can write this. Okay, I agree with the above statement. So, above dekho to statement hona chahiye. Fine? Every time I am repeating this because 90% of the students do that mistake. कि statement लिखते ही नहीं है और बोलते हैं कि above देखो, above किधर देखो, teacher किधर देखेगी above, right? Okay. So in question number one also I told, second also I told, third also I am telling कि please write the statement because we are not in standard third. Okay. Now next point is, what is the definition of TU? Utility derived from all the units consumed. Matlab sab mangoes khane ke baad jo utility milti hai, that is total utility. And what is marginal utility? Satisfaction derived from additional unit consumed, that is a MU. Additional bole to fifth mango. In my example, fifth mango's utility, that is MU. At a stage comes where MU is zero, means it does not want extra mango. He is totally satisfied, his tummy is totally filled with that. Stomach is full. Bas. Nahi chahiye. Aur dege to vomit aa jayegi. Okay, fine. Now back to next question, which is a small one. Demand and desire. The question is, beta. All desires are demand. This is the question. Now, all desires are demand. Is that the same statement? No. I do not agree with above statement or I disagree with above statement. Because the concept of demand and concept of desires are different. Demand contains three things. Desire, ability and willingness. All these three things come together, then it becomes demand. And desire bole to just a dream. I want this, but I don't have money in the pocket. I don't have a ability. Then, is that a demand? No, it is not a demand, right? So in short, beggar's demand is not a demand, it is a desire. So desire and demand both are different things, students. Just remember, desire and demand both are different, because desire matlab wish. Haan, mujhe 90% chahiye, 95% chahiye, that is my desire. But what about the ability? What about the hard work I put? If I does not put any efforts into it, then it is a desire. Okay? So back to my example, ki beggar's demand is not a demand, because he has a desire to wish that car. Ki I want that car. But he does not have a money. Fine? If he has a money, then it is his demand. Because demand includes three things. Demand ka formula hai. Desire, ability, willingness. If all these things are there, then only it is demand. If one of the thing is absent, it is not a demand. Okay? I think everything is clear, because again, it is June, May, June part. This is just a revision, students. So no need to explain more. I'll just show you this. Take a screenshot. I think no need to read all these things. Means I will not read. You will read at home. Okay. Let us do. What? Yes. Subscribe me. Share me. And like me. And watch this video till end. And concentrate. Just for 15 minutes, because I have already told in previous video that you can take a break of 6 to 7 days, because you also want change. Break lene ke baad fresh ho jaoge aur achhi studies karoge, right? Okay, now I hope everything is clear today. If any doubt, you can drop a message on WhatsApp. WhatsApp will be better. You can even drop a message here, but that is convenient for me, because we have different groups. In group, it is very easy to discuss everything, right? Okay, now just take a screen. Yeah, you can see, na? This. Yes, I think you can see. Clear? First question is regarding scope of microeconomics is unlimited. This is the answer. All distinguished answers are there. Distinguished points are there. Then microeconomics is different from macroeconomics. Again, all distinguished points are there.